Okay, now we have seen the cyclic loading conditions, and the based on that, let's solve one numerical here. So before, now this is the numerical, that is a ball bearing is operating on a work cycle, and it consists of three parts. One is the radial load of 3000 newton at 1440 rpm for one quarter cycle. A radial load of 5000 newton at 720 rpm for an half cycle. And radial load of 2500 newton at 1440 rpm for the remaining cycle. Now the expected life of the bearing is what? 10,000 hours it is given. We need to calculate dynamic load carrying capacity of the bearing. Now consider the work cycle of 1 minute duration. Okay. So N1 is equal to 1/4 into 1440 times is equal to 360 revolution. N2 will be what? 360 revolution. N3 is what? 360. So N1, N2, N3, all threes are same. So the average speed of rotation is given by N1 plus N2 plus N3 is equal to 1080 rpm. So small n is equal to 1080 rpm. Now we know the dynamic loading condition equation, that is P is equal to cube root of N1 P1 cube plus N2 P2 cube plus N3 P3 cube whole thing divided by N1 plus N2 plus N3. Put this value of N1, P1, all these things here. Okay, we put it, we get, that is 3823 newton. You can use a calculator also to find out this value. Now life of bearing, that is L10, is equal to what? 60 times n, L10 hours by 10 to the power 6. N is what? 1080. L10 hours is what? 10,000. 10 to the power 6, 648 million revolution we get here. So based on this, dynamic load is what? Equivalent load is needed, and even the life in a million revolution is needed. So P is here 3823 and L10 is here 648. Bracket raised to 1/3. So it is 33082 newton. This one dynamic load is acting on it. You can see the design table also. That is the dynamic load table, and you can find out which bearing is suitable to this number. So this is how you can solve the numerical. If you want, you can comment me or you can send me a request also. I will give you other numerical videos also. Thank you.